Sport that's been saved from extinction. Brunswick stopped making air hockey tables in the mid-70s, but these guys weren't ready to quit playing.
We all started buying them for $50, $75, putting them in our garages and practicing and holding our own tournaments.
And we've turned what was just a game into a sport with tactics and strategy.
Phil and some of his former classmates from the U of H contacted other players around the country and formed a national association. And they've rescued a lot of used tables from the scrap heap, and now they're trying to duplicate a complex plastic used to make the pucks. And twice each year they meet in Houston or Colorado for a national tournament and some classic competition.
When you're playing at 3 o'clock in the morning and you're down a 5-2 to Jesse Doughty, national champion, come back and you beat him, that's just a euphoric feeling.
Yep, these guys play serious. Air blown through hundreds of holes on the playing field make the puck float at speeds close to 100 miles an hour. And the aforementioned Doughty, an 8-time national champion, thinks out a whole series of shots ahead of time, much like chess. But others are more intuitive. Yet they all agree there's a lot of mental exercise involved here.
You can train a guy's reflexes. And if you train his reflexes to move to the right, with say 15 off-goal shots to the person's right, then he's right for a shot to his left.
Because it's a one-on-one player sport, you can't sort of slack off and let your teammates cover for you. So, you know, it's either get tough or die on the air hockey table.
And Dubuisson would go on to win this national title 4-3 in the finals over Hernandez. But he didn't have nearly as much trouble against me, scoring on his first shot.
Never know where the puck's going to go if you keep moving around.
Well, that's for sure. I had no idea. This was an exercise in frustration and fear for me. Bob beat me 7-3. The 200 or so competitive members of the National Association are the epitome of true sportsmen. They work at this because they love it. That's it. No ulterior motives like money.
No, it's not for the money. I can't hustle at it. It's very because not enough people think they're good at it. So, no, it's real pure.
With the National Air Table Hockey Association, that's a timeout. I'm Bruce Geetson.